Hi, my name is August, and let's take a deep dive into the world of voice acting. And today, we're gonna follow three budding voice actresses as they follow their dreams in the voice acting industry. Being in such a competitive field, our heroines will have to struggle in order to be successful. But while they face rivals and critics everywhere they go, their biggest adversary are their own selves. Today, let's take a look at Ninki Seiyuu, how to make a pop voice actress. And with that said, let's begin. For such a cutthroat industry in Japan, Ninki Seiyuu takes the casual approach to detailing the lives of our actresses. Tasked with taking care of a dormitory housing female talents, Keito Nagakura, along with his sister Konatsu, ends up meeting two rising voice actors, Itsumi Seno, the struggling hard worker, and Yukako Kurusu, the idol of his dreams. There, Keito is dedicated to making sure his friends have the best possible experience when following their career path, both in love and in life, even if he's retired from the entertainment world for good. Now, they all might be rivals when it comes to competing for anime roles, TV appearances, and love itself, but they're all friends by the end of the day, and the visual novel chooses to highlight that. Ninki Seiyuu is very lighthearted when it comes to its slice of life story. They're all understanding and supportive of each other, especially when it feels like half the cast are members of Team Out of a Job. Love affairs are also on the table as well, being very receptive when the lovey-dovey couple get together. Although that doesn't excuse Noah, aka Best Girl, from teasing them endlessly. That said, the visual novel doesn't hold back in tackling its serious dramatic moments either. Ninki Seiyuu, How to Make a Pop Voice Actress is like what the title describes, a mostly realistic glimpse into the voice acting industry. A lot of its inner workings are explored here, and they're tied into the characterization of the heroines as they learn the tips and tricks of the trade, and making many mistakes along the way. They may be small errors, but even the most minuscule of issues, like accidentally bumping into the mic or having to take a sick day, can feel like the career ended right then and there. Despite those issues, however, it's how our heroines manage to overcome their problems with the guidance and support of others that makes it a compelling drama. And now it's time to talk about our beloved voice actresses. Yukako Kurusu is our celebrity voice actor, rapidly rising to the ranks and winning the hearts of everyone with her beauty. But for how much of an expert she is behind the mic, she's a very soft-spoken girl in real life. A character that's perfect at whispering sweet nothings with that ASMR voice, and a character route that not once, but twice got me with a pun that left me in excruciating pain. Reserved and gentle character types like Yukako aren't usually my favorite, but with how the visual novel handled her characterization, I ended up really liking her. And it's not just her sweet, affectionate side turned assertive in her H scenes. As one might expect, being a famous celebrity has its own internal struggles and bad actors to watch out for. She may be the hottest idol on the block, but Yukako's prestigious status and high expectations from others is the very reason why she can't show weakness. The issue isn't getting canceled on social media, or receiving toxic comments, or suffering under the rage of angry Redditors, although that's problematic in its own right, but rather her own personal doubts in her own self. What if she's just nothing but a pretty face? What if she's just a tool for an elaborate PR stunt? What if she's just another actress to make merchandise off of? She thinks that her own abilities aren't up to par. And again, this is made apparent by the fact that a talented newbie, one that we'll be talking about in a bit, can easily overshadow her. What's worse is that she's also the type to bottle issues inside. These are very real issues that just about anyone can have, especially when working in the entertainment industry. It's this type of introspective conflict that the visual novel engages with each of its characters. However, they aren't alone. It's the caring people around them that's willing to support them in their troubles. All that's required is to open up to them. Whether it's a cheeky friend, a trusted advisor, or a guild member that's down to do some fishing in an MMORPG. Konatsu is our newest rising star on the block, and it's through her that we get a more formal introduction to the world of voice acting. Konatsu is a very energetic and cheerful girl, helping as a fellow caretaker of the dorm. She's there to brighten up the conversation with her energy, often ribbing off of her beloved brother, with a smile that's unintentionally kinda scary. After being discovered that she's naturally talented, she's been added to the agency's roster. But while she's hardworking and dedicated to the role in practice, she crumbles when put to the test. To be quite honest, I hate watching this. Not because I dislike like it, but because I personally find it extremely painful to watch. It's like internally cringing when a performer makes a mistake on stage. A minor mistake, sure, but as a performer, it's a memory that will eternally haunt you. It's that beginner anxiety that Konatsu's route embodies, that fear of having to do constant retakes, causing trouble for the staff, and overall feeling like an annoyance. Add this onto the fact that she was scouted for her natural talent, overshadowing the more experienced girls, and you have a character that feels the pressure. Luckily for Konatsu, this little sister is powered off of her big brother energy, and in turn, emanating those little sister pheromones purely from this one image alone. By being put into a supportive role, Kaito's there to help the girls, developing their talents and watching their mental health, and in this case, inspiring Konatsu by being by her side, despite the slightly passionate horniness. I mean, what more can you expect from an affectionate bro-con-sis-con relationship? Seems pretty clear-cut to me where this train ride's going. One that includes 8 scenes that go on longer than one might expect. And last but not least, we have Itsumi Seno, a voice actress who just really needs a goddamn break. Itsumi is a hardworking individual putting her best foot forward in any of her roles, at least the very few of them anyway. While she can get a job as an unnamed extra, she's stuck in a rut, continuously failing to get any major roles at all. She isn't a natural like Konatsu is, or a breakout beauty celebrity like Yukako, so it's up to her raw experience and constant hustle alone to break through. The entertainment world is harsh, and not everyone makes it through. There's going to be a point where those failures break someone's spirit. In fact, there's already a couple of instances here that we explore into. However, it's Itsumi's pure dedication, passion, and determination to keep moving forward that had me rooting for her every step of the way, even if I cringe at the shitty roles that she's been given. But maybe that's all a part of her charm, to be able to take those voice acting roles and perform them to the best of her abilities, even getting in some real world experience in, including the mature older woman seductive
type.
It's also helpful from a romantic perspective since Itsumi is also the most flustered when it comes to such affairs. My personal favorite out of all the pairs, considering their rocky start. Mostly because of all the cheeky and charming activities they do together to help Itsumi get more practice in.
Write that down!
In conclusion, Ninki Seiyuu, How to Make a Pop Voice Actress is a well-grounded romantic comedy drama that follows these young voice actresses as they passionately work towards their dreams. It isn't without conflict, however, as each of the heroines experience many difficulties and troubles, all of which are deeply personal. It's these type of internal conflicts that Ninki Seiyuu engages with and does a great job at exploring. Throughout the different routes, the characters are able to overcome their self-doubt thanks to the support of others and regain their inner strength and passions. It's one of the reasons why I really like these works that have a focus on the creative industry or idols in general. There's something compelling about an individual's rise to fame and how they overcome adversity that's inspiring and makes you want to root for them. Ninki Seiyuu unfortunately does fall into the typical anime rom-com pitfalls more than I would personally like, given how close to the real-life spectrum this visual novel feels. There's also the fact that the best supporting girl doesn't have a route, but that's a minor nitpick I'll have to live with. Overall, Ninki Seiyuu is a pleasant visual novel with an insightful look into the industry and its characters. One to pick up for those looking for a more drama-focused story while also having your romantic comedy on the side as well. Ninki Seiyuu, How to Make a Pop Voice Actress gets a 4 out of 5 with a seal of recommendation from me. And as always, subscribe if you like the video and want to see more. Check back every week for new content. For more of my thoughts, you can follow me on Twitter at TheAugustHale.